Hi everybody, so today I'm going to design my own nails, yay! I've always got some sort of plan in my head, but it hardly ever works out the way I plan, and usually it's something totally different. So I've got my acrylic gel, and I've applied a matte top coat on top of this one, because I'm going to start off with my what I usually like to call my accent nail. Okay, how can I do this? Because it needs to focus, of course. Okay, so I don't really have a plan yet. We'll just see how this goes. And hopefully I can stay in frame while designing my own nails. I'm just gonna start and we'll see. As I go. So it's pretty hard doing your own nails and staying in frame, especially when you're not a pro. I mean, I am a pro in doing nails, just not recording. So that's good. Let me just give it a flash cure so I won't mess it up. I'm just hoping that I'm going to like my design and I'm not going to be taking it off like that tomorrow. Because that is how I roll if I don't like what I've created. when I'm doing my drawings. It's just so hard to breathe. And it's going to be such a hassle to make the other to make the other spaces wide, you know, but you know, I don't like my nails real thick, so I'd rather, well, let me just flash cure that. I'd rather you know, draw the white on in between than just the white layer first, because it adds to the thickness. I really don't like thick nails. Grab a different brush. Nails by Dev did a design like this with her Mario Kart nails. Love those nails, I did. But I don't have the time to create all my little figurines, and I'm not that into, you know, I love black nails, I do. I think that they are gorgeous, but it's just, it's not for me. I bumped it. Why did I bump it? Let me fix that. I bumped it because I wasn't paying attention. See how close I fixed it. I think so. Okay. And again, let's give it a flash. Yeah, flash cure. So I am going to clean this brush and my other brush. Which shall I use? I guess my number two. My number three is too long, and my number one is if I use my number one, it's easier to go over the other lines because the tip is just not as tapered. So that's what I'm going to do with all the little squares. I will be doing this off camera because it will take way too long. Be right back. So I've made all the squares like that, and now I got out my CareforNailz. It's also a striper brush, but it's a bit thicker than the other brushes. So I've got loads of brushes, just so many. Okay, let's see. So I've got these. Now I'll have to decide what I like. Let's see. Oh, so much to choose from. I don't know if you can hear it on film, but my stomach is making all kinds of noises, so I don't know why. Do you need an extra coat of that later on? So I like how this brush is, you know, it's a striper brush. Of course, you can make very small lines with it, but it's just, I guess, thick and small enough to get in between those small spaces, but I can still use it to blend polishes with. Let's see. I'm probably gonna switch over to your brush, because the area will be just too wide to work with such a small brush. And next, maybe this color, same color I've got on my other hand. I'm just going to take my time until I've got what I want. Like I said, I just don't want to have to take it off tomorrow because, you know, I don't like it anymore. Queen's going to need a second coat of, with those colors. So, let's do that. Going to take my green again. Yes. Let me just get back. So I'm expecting mail today, but this was just a salesman. I hate it when they show up like that. But I guess they're just doing their job. I always try very hard to stay off of the skin, you know, with my own nails, but also with my clients' nails. It's very important. You do not touch the skin with anything, basic things, instead of your, except for your oil. But other than that, when using your cleaner or your acrylic liquid, or, you know, it doesn't really matter, except for that it's really, really, really important to stay off of the skin. That's to prevent allergies, and they happen just so often. It's a shame, really. It shouldn't have to, but yeah. Especially here in Holland. You know, anybody can do nails. You don't have to be educated to do nails. But, of course, you really do have to be educated to do nails. With all of the products you're working with, but also understanding how the nail unit works and even understanding what products you're using, you know, and all the risks involved. People tend to look at nails as like, well, like regular nail polish, which it's absolutely not. Absolutely, absolutely not the same. Used too much of the purple. This purple is just so pigmented. I will do this just a little bit off camera because it's easier for me to see, and then I will be right back. So I am curing right now, and I am going to take my black, and then I'm just gonna trace this line to get it nice and crisp. Just like that. That looks way better, I guess. All right, let me give that another cure. And then I am going to apply my No Glanz top coat. Love this top coat. I'm still thinking if maybe I should add some champagne blush, because I am a glitter girl. Well, you know, I can try, see if it works, if I like that. Lay my brush. maybe just over there. Yes, I like that. Just a little sparkle. Yeah, I like that. Let me give that a cure again. But that's how it works. And after that, I am going to add my glossy top coat. And some stars, and then I'm done with this nail, and then I've got only 4 left, which I will show you in another video. So that's done. Get that finger upside down so the top coat is really nice and smooth, and let's cure that, and I will be right back. So that's fully cured. So I'm going to add some stars. Oh, sorry, bumped the camera. Trying to do everything so you can see, but sometimes, you know, I just can't do a straight line without taking my hand just off camera for just a second. Oh, that's cute, isn't it? I like that. Maybe just a small one over there, but let me just cure that for a bit. Or at least just a flash cure so I won't mess it up. I just love looking at how the other nail decks design their nails, and then I will just try to make something that's my own. And of course, I've got my own ideas, but you know, nothing wrong with admitting that there are some pretty big nail tags out there. And for me, it doesn't matter who you are. Just look at the work. And if I like it, then I like it. If I don't, I don't. Yeah, that's cute. I'm going to cure that for 30 seconds. And I am going to take some very, very small rhinestones. And yes, yeah, some very small rhinestones that I will place inside the center of those two stars. Ooh. My gem gel and my pickup tool. And since these stones are like really, really, really small, I don't have to place them in base and then top and then seal them around with top coat, because that's what I usually do. When I'm using the bigger stones, yeah, this is a tiny blingy. Love that. I'm gonna give it a full cure and then I'll be right back. So this is what I've got. My first nail on this hand. So next up, I'm going to design the other nails, which I will show you in a different video. So thank you for watching. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and I'll see you next time.